In this tutorial, I'll be walking us through the getting started of Oracle Database 11G Express Edition and the Oracle Application Express. But before we proceed, I just want to make sure that you have the software installed. So if you followed the instructions on my how to download and install Oracle Database 11G Express Edition, then we're good to go. If not, I suggest you take a look at that first and come back when you're done. I'll post the link to the video on the description below. After the installation, you will notice that there is a new icon on the desktop. It's for the getting started with Oracle Database 11 Express Edition. So let's go ahead and click on that. It will basically open a web page where you can manage or administer the Oracle Database software. Okay, there we go. So basically we have the storage sessions parameters, and here is the Oracle Application Express. So let's go there. Okay, during the installation we had to set up a password for the sys and system user account, so let's go ahead and put those in. I'm gonna use system for the user. I'm gonna enter my password. Okay, here we go. This is where we are going to create a workspace where we can do some work within the Oracle Application Express. So the Oracle database comes pre-configured with an HR schema where there are test data there. So I prefer to use that instead. So go ahead and click on use existing, then let's click on the HR. Gonna go ahead and create a username for this one. Just say admin. Then create a password. Okay, so now we're good to go on creating the workspace. Okay, once you're done, you'll see the message above. Successfully created workspace HR. Begin click here to log in. Okay, this is the name of the workspace that the software has created. Now, the username that we created, and then enter the password. Okay, so this is the user interface of the Oracle Application Express. I think this is version 4.0.2. This is actually an old version. So if you want to download the latest version, I can probably, I'll set up another video on that. You can see here you have the home, the application builder. You can create database application, Webshift application, then the SQL workshop. This is where you can perform data manipulations or create objects. So you have here the object browser. Okay, add space or list the tables, use indexes, sequences, and other database objects. You can also perform SQL commands here. So for example, if you want to select all the records from employees table, go ahead and enter that and then click on run. Okay, so this will give you the data in a sort of like spreadsheet format. Then we have SQL scripts. You can upload scripts here that you can execute later on. And then next we have the query builder. If you're not familiar with SQL commands, then you can go here and just select the data that you want to see. For example, employees, then select the columns or fields that you want to appear on the results, and then click run. You can see here on the SQL tab the generated SQL commands. Okay, next are utilities. We have the data workshop, object reports, generate DDL, data definition language, user interface defaults, cycle viewing, then keep going to the next one, the team development. I cannot then focus much on the team development because I haven't actually used that. So let's go to the administration. So here you can manage users and groups of the workspace. So in this case we have the pre-generated or pre-created user during the workspace creation, which is the admin. You can also create other users here, and then you can define their roles. They are administrator, developer, both, and none. Then for groups, this is for security framework. By default, there are no groups yet. So you can define groups if you are building a sort of security access for your application. Can manage services. This is can set up the workspace preferences here. Okay, going back home, let's go ahead and create an application. Let's go to your application builder. We're going to create from scratch, so let's click on the create button. Okay, there are three types of application: database, spreadsheet, and sample applications. Sample applications are pre-built applications where you can choose from. Let's go ahead and click that so I can show you. Okay, so install a demo application. Okay, it seems that we are missing some privilege here, so we need to fix that. Okay, on the installation software, I mentioned before that there's a new item in the program, so go ahead and click that and run with the SQL command line. So we're going to connect as sys again. Enter the password. Okay, we need to grant some permissions to the HR user in order to be able to create the table views tables. Okay, so yeah. I'm just gonna grant all to the user to prevent to make this simple. And going back to the auto application stress. Okay, once the installation is complete, you will see here pre-installed pages for the application. So in order to run the application, just click here. This is the login page that was pre-installed. This can actually be modified, so let's just proceed with the demo application for now. So by default, two accounts are created in the sample application, so let's use demo for now. And then logics. Okay, so basically this is the web application. So here we go. So we have four tabs, home, customers, products, orders, and reports. And then these are dashboards for some data. So let's go ahead and go to the customers tab. Okay, here you can see the list of customers. Then create customer here, edit create customer or edit customer. Then go to products. Okay, these are the products. Same with the customers, can create a product and or update a product or delete a product. Then here are the orders. So these are the existing orders. As you can see here, order number one, customer, ordered three items. So So you can save changes, delete order, add items to order, or delete orders. And you can also enter the order here. So basically, you need to select a system customer to open the customer. So we're going to select one. These are the customers on the customer internet database. So if you need to create one, you just click here or go back to customers and then create one. And then these are the reports. So. Okay. Okay, so basically this is the quick overview of the Oracle application Express built with the built-in on the Oracle database 11 day Express edition. Okay, thanks for watching.